Retro. No.
Hey, this is Catherine Tabor, Senator Padme Amidala from Star Wars The Clone Wars, and you're listening to Jay and Dennis on Podcast Stardust. Stay on the light side.
This is Podcast Stardust.
This station is now the ultimate power in the universe.
With Dennis Keithley and Jay Krebs.
Your behavior is continually unexpected.
The galaxy source for Star Wars news, reviews, and discussion.
Now witness the firepower of this fully armed and operational battle station.
Hello there, Star Wars fans. I'm Jay Krebs.
And I'm Dennis Keithley.
And this is another fully armed and operational edition of Podcast Stardust, the galaxy source for Star Wars news, reviews, and discussion. But before we get started on this month's special edition of Podcast Stardust, Dennis, where can our listeners find us on social media?
We are conveniently located on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at Podcast Stardust.
All right. Welcome to episode 526 of Podcast Stardust. Today, we are bringing you a special monthly feature called World Between Worlds, a mystical dimension that connects Star Wars fashion and lifestyle products to your space and time. The goal is to bring you a wide variety of ideas for products to surround you, outfit you, and bind your style sense together, kind of like the Force. So, happy Valentine's Day! If you are celebrating the holiday, regardless of to whom you show your love, you will hear about products today suited for a significant other, a child, friendship, or just to let someone special know that you appreciate that person, and some other just relatively new general kinds of things that are available out there in the Star Wars fashion and lifestyle galaxy. So, you know, after all, we don't want you looking for love in Alderaan places. And no one likes to be solo, right, Dennis?
Yeah.
We think all of our listeners are too great, and you Ewok our world.
Indeed.
And we are so glad you choose us for your Star Wars podcasting fun.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you say? Jawanna be our Valentines? Okay, we've mauled you enough with the puns. I couldn't resist, Dennis. I'm sorry.
That's all right.
It was really bad. Time for some Star Wars fashion and lifestyle fun. But as always, Dennis and I like to fill everyone in on any recent acquisitions or updates on products that we currently have. So, Dennis, anything new for you or any updates you have?
No, not since last month. And typically Valentine's Day, something usually shows up. So I'm hoping to have an update for next month.
Awesome. Yeah, you and Beth always do some really special stuff, so I'm excited to see how your month goes. So for me, actually, it's kind of been crazy this last month. It's almost like Christmas all over again for me. I've just been gifted a bunch of things, and one of those was actually from your wife, Beth. She got me those two fig pins that we talked about last month on World Between Worlds that kind of went along with what you had. So she sent me the Mandalorian armor and the Ahsoka version of the Mandalorian version of Ahsoka, I should say. And so those are now in my cosplay room. So I'm very, very excited about those. So that was awesome. So thanks again, Beth. And then long story short, I friended a small business owner here in my hometown, and she does a like repurposing of fashion. So she basically goes out and thrifts from other places and then resells them. And so we just kind of got to talking, and she knew that I was a Star Wars fan. And so she brought me in just randomly these Grogu salt and pepper shaker and a little mini waffle maker, which is so adorable. So the salt and pepper shaker is ceramic. And so the pram is one of the shakers. I guess you could decide which you wanted to do with which. And then Grogu himself is the other shaker. So he's got three little holes in the top of his head. But there's a magnet that holds the two of them together, which is really cool. So Grogu sits in the pram, essentially. And then you've got your little salt and pepper shaker set, which is absolutely adorable. And then the little mini waffle maker is basically like about 5 inches, I think, across, if that. So they're literally like little teeny tiny waffles, but the top of it is, I like to call it Grogu green, and it's got a picture of Grogu in the pram. And then the inside, one layer of the plates for the waffle maker is like a traditional, you know, waffle style. And then the other is Grogu in the pram. So just like you see on the top of the lid, that's what imprints onto the waffle. So I haven't used that one yet. I'm really excited to do so, but just haven't had time to have, you know, like a good weekend breakfast. So I'm going to have to do that at some point. But I've never seen these before. I've seen the little waffle maker before, but I've never seen the salt and pepper shaker before. Have you ever seen that anywhere?
No, not a Grogu salt and pepper shaker. I've seen R2 and 3PO, and I think I have those in my closet somewhere. But never Grogu. So, but he's showing up in practically everything these days. You want a Grogu themed any kitchen utensil, and I bet you can find it.
Oh yeah, I'm sure you could. Absolutely. So yeah, the salt and pepper shaker, I'm thinking it's about 4 inches tall once you put the whole thing together. So if nothing else, it makes for a nice little decor kind of thing. So that was a lot of fun. And then in the cosplay world, J.Snoop's cosplay, I was actually gifted a set of custom stickers from one of my cosplay friends, Star Spangled Comet, which I've talked about quite a bit. And so she took one of the photos of me with my little Morai on my wrist, and she actually drew me in cartoon form and then created stickers for me. So I will be making those available pretty soon. I'm planning to have some sort of a giveaway for reaching a milestone of followers. I'm thinking probably either 2,500 or 3,000. So those will be available there. And of course, I'll have them at Fan Expo Cleveland to pass around as well. So that was fun. And then I was just kind of messing around on Poshmark, and which is probably not a good idea for me. And I found this line. I've actually been looking for it, so I shouldn't say that I just fell into this. But it's a line called On the Bias. So it's BYAS. And so that line was actually originally released in 2015 through PacSun. So it's kind of really beachy, kind of skater, you know, that kind of motif or aesthetic, if you will. And so what I was able to find was this, I call it Scarif-themed Stormtrooper hoodie. It's actually a men's, but I just got the small version. And so the pocket on this is white, and then it has like palm trees in sort of an aqua color and black. And then it's got the Stormtroopers, and it's sort of in a collage motif. And then the same material is on the inside of the hoodie itself, the hood. But I like the way it's put together, because the hood it's attached to almost like a really thick regular neckline kind of a thing. So it's not the V-neck neckline that you typically get with hoodies. And so it's kind of a charcoal gray, and the bottom of it where the pocket is attached actually is black with white dots. So it kind of looks like a star field in a way, and it's super comfortable. So again, I found that one on Poshmark, and they do actually have a lot of different types of things on Poshmark that you can get because you can't get them through PacSun anymore, unfortunately. They've just been discontinued. But there's t-shirts, again, there's sweatshirts, there's three-quarter length sleeve shirts, all kinds of different fun things, but they all have that fun kind of beachy collage type motif. So if you're looking for a fun, pretty inexpensive, I think I picked this one up for $18, and originally they sell for $50. So yeah, and that was even with shipping. So I thought that was a pretty good deal.
Yeah, nice secondhand find.
Mm-hmm, absolutely. Yeah, I love Poshmark. I actually did end up ordering something else from Poshmark, which I'll talk about next month because it's not here yet. So I will save that one. So now it's time to get into the new stuff for this month. And as promised, we do have some Valentine gets here. So the first thing on the list is from Enso, E-N-S-O. And we've talked about them before here on World Between Worlds. They are popular for their silicone rings, which is really in right now for people that, especially working in different types of careers where they may not be able to wear a traditional ring to work. So Enso now has just dropped a new line for bracelets. And so this is a line that's been inspired by their top selling rings. And this is the I Love You, I Know series, which of course is the classic love line in Star Wars. And so right from their website, it just says, I love you, I know, the most powerful words in the galaxy. And that shows up in Ourivesh on the bracelets themselves. So there's a few different styles of bracelets that you can get. So there's one that they call the Black Pearl, which is all black with the metal that says the I love you, I know. So you can get these in sets. So you can get one for yourself and you can get one for your significant other. And so it kind of reminds me of those Mezpa coins. I don't know if you remember those from the 80s. They were kind of broken down the middle and you would give half to like your boyfriend or girlfriend and then you mm-hmm. have the other half. Do you remember those?
Yeah.
So it's
yeah.
kind of in that same sort of a feel, if you will. And so there's the Black Pearl. There's one called Icy Silver, which is more of a gray with like a rose gold type of metal on the band itself. And so the clasp and sleeve are actually rose gold. And then there's one that's all rose gold, which I'm always a sucker for those. So those are the four. So you've got your black, icy silver, and I'm sorry, the three, and the rose gold. And so basically these are about what they call their standard width, which is 4.25 millimeters, which is almost a quarter of an inch wide. There is a size guide on their website, actually. So if you're interested in these, they have both a PDF guide and a video guide. So it'll take you through it. And right now they're on sale for $67.49, down from $89.99. And these are actually really nice looking. I really like these. They're not, again, at that quarter inch, they're not super wide and they make a statement without, you know, being too chunky.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. Those are very stylish, very classic looking. And I can't speak to the bracelets, but I do know that one of the instructors where my kids take martial arts has some of the Enso rings that he wears when he's not wearing it. So he does not wear his regular wedding band when he is instructing martial arts. And it's quite great quality and it's fantastic. So good products from Enso.
Well, good. That's good to hear because I don't have any experience with them, but I've been seeing them like all over the place. So that's good to know. Mm-hmm. All right. Well, moving on, just we have one more jewelry related item here. And again, Girls Crew is at it once again. And we've talked about them before. And I know Beth's got some Girls Crew that she picked up at Star Wars Celebration Anaheim last May. And so they actually have a new launch with a couple of different styles available. So there is what they call the Star Wars, the Mandalorian, and Grogu Love is the Way studs. Aw, I love that. And then that is a two-pack, which comes with, as you can guess, the Mandalorian and Grogu. So these two are in a gold tone with some of the jewels. And this two set actually comes in a couple different metals. So the one that they feature is in gold, but you can also get it in rose gold and you can get it in silver. So no matter what your metal of choice is, they do have that. And those are actually available right now for $48. And so the description on these is, I love this, it says, love is in the air. What better way to celebrate than with a pairing as perfect as the Mandalorian and Grogu? Fall head over heels for the lovable duo as they each gleam in the prettiest shade of pink. To top it off, the beloved Grogu can be spotted holding onto an adorably charming heart. So there you go. So the gold is 18 karat and the silver is sterling silver posts and they have the butterfly backings and cubic zirconia stones. So these are teeny tiny and that's basically what they're known for is the smaller stones that are, again, you know, not super chunky. And then the other set is called Star Wars Sparks Fly Droids Stud Set. So this is actually a set of three. And in this set, it says, I don't know if our circuits are acting up, but I'm sensing a real spark here. Our Star Wars Sparks Fly Droid Stud Set features R2-D2, BB-8, and C-3PO like you've never seen them before. In the most vibrant shades of pink and embellished with the cutest heart detailing, These droids are sure to make you fall in love at first sight. And once again, these are all in the pink tones. C-3PO's eyes are hearts, and then R2 is looks like he's got just a heart right in the front of him, and then BB-8's got hearts all over him. So again, these are available in their gold, rose gold, and in silver, and these are also on sale for $58. So you can get all three sets for the 58. And these are so cute. I love all the girls crew. I haven't gotten anything yet from them. I've been tempted, but I have not yet. And I know, like I said, Beth really likes hers.
Oh yeah. Yeah. She really enjoyed getting those at Celebration, and she's worn them a few times since then.
That's cool. Very good. Well, again, all of these will be, links will be in our show notes. So if anything trips your fancy, you can head over there and you can check all of these out. And all right, so on to our fur babies. We love our fur babies, of course, here on Podcast Stardust. And we both have two dogs. You have Loki and Zeb, and then I have Leia and Gunner. So buckle down. I actually found this particular product that I'm going to talk about in just a second through a photo that someone had posted on Instagram. And I was like, oh my gosh, I need to find out where this is from. But the specific product I'll talk about in just a second, but Buckle Down has 23 pages of Star Wars products. I was really surprised. Yeah. So they are actually well known, or most known, I should say, for their seatbelt inspired type belts. And I do have a few of those. And then they also have, you know, the collars for pets and whatnot. But I was looking through all of their pages. I didn't get through all 23, but I was kind of clicking around, and they have everything from wallets and wristlets, phone cases, lanyards, crossbody bags, fanny packs. And the fanny packs are both in the original style and the new style of fanny packs, which are called crossbody wallets now. And instead of around your waist, you're supposed to wear them almost like a bandolier. So that's new. But they also have keychains, dog toys, pet collars, leashes, chain belts with charms, and even pet carriers, which is kind of fun. But the whole reason that I was looking for Buckle Down was because I was looking for this Ahsoka themed pet bed, which is all quilted, and it's just so cute. So the inside of the pet bed is like a darker brown, and it's got three sections of quilting, and then the inside of it is the orange and white of Ahsoka's face and her face markings, and it has Star Wars in white as well. And then the outside is blue and white, so like Ahsoka's head tails and montrails. And then it's also basically rimmed in this brown cording kind of a thing to kind of hold it all together. And the bed is actually part of their Bounding Elements collection. So they have a whole section of nothing but they call these Bounding Elements. And there's a few other Star Wars characters as well. So an R2 bed and an Imperial Fleet bed, which actually I really like that one. That one I feel like is a lot, I wouldn't say it's more aesthetically pleasing necessarily, but I feel like that's one that would blend into decor maybe a little bit more, unless you specifically had these other colors in your house. But I mean, if mm-hmm. you're not really trying to like match colors, it doesn't really matter. But I love this Imperial Fleet bed. But there's no Leia products. I was really like sad about that. I was like, okay, if I can find Leia a new collar, I will totally get that for her for Valentine's Day, you know, but they didn't. I was a little disappointed. So Buckle Down, if you're listening, you need to buckle down and you need to come up with some Leia products. But I did find a whole line of Loki products for your little fur baby, but they didn't have anything for Zeb. They didn't have any Rebels stuff. So that was kind of a bummer, but you could definitely get Loki set up with a lot of fun stuff.
Yeah, we actually have a Loki collar for Loki, and for Zeb, we just went with the standard color collar, but they're both buckle type collars and stuff like that. So it's fun to have, but yeah, it is fun to treat the dogs with these type of things that we're interested in.
Yeah, absolutely. So yeah, so head over to Buckle Down if you need anything for those fur babies. They have cat collars, dog collars, you know, everything that you can possibly imagine. And again, if you're just looking for a general gift to give or something for yourself, chances are you'll find something. All right, so moving on. This one came up on an Instagram sponsored ad for me, and I do follow Beeline Creative. but this is a new one. So if you're not aware, after listening to some of our other episodes, this is the 40th anniversary of Return of the Jedi. So it was released in 1983. And so a lot of companies are jumping on the bandwagon of that celebration, and Beeline Creative and Geeki Tiki is what they're known for, is also jumping on that. And so you can raise a glass and share a toast with someone that you love, but they have a Return of the Jedi themed full-size mug made from their mini muglets line, many of which are either sold out or retired. So the reason that they put it out on Instagram is because they were asking people to vote for the muglet that they wanted to have made into the full-sized mug. So I thought that was kind of cool, you know, to involve their fans and their patrons and things in that decision. So I actually messaged them and said, you know, when will you know which one you're going to make? And they hadn't gotten back to me, but so stay tuned and we'll see which one actually ends up winning and which one they actually end up making into the full-size mug. But for example, the C-3PO muglet was available as an exclusive in Star Wars Celebration Chicago in 2019, and it is no longer available. And honestly, out of the four that they had, I really liked that one the most. So they had, I just thought that one kind of made the most sense overall out of all four. So the four that are actually available to vote for, if you go to Beeline Creative, is that C-3PO that I just mentioned. And there's a Salacious Crumb and the Bib Fortuna. And the fourth one is Ula. So you've got a gold. Yeah, you've got a gold and kind of the light brown, and then the Salacious Crumb, which is Salacious Crumb. And then Ula is the green. So it'll be interesting to see which one they actually come up with.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So fun.
Yeah, these are always fun. It's always fun to see what they come up with when they do these. It's a neat style if you're into collecting those things. And I've got so many different mugs and glasses in my house that I haven't picked up any of these. But it is it's always a neat collection. And, you know, these tiki, it's a whole culture unto itself.
It
and
is.
So, yeah, you want to blend Star Wars with that. And that could please really two big fandoms.
Yeah, for sure. And I've seen people that have used these even as succulent planters. So, you know, you can always, you know, use them in your decor if you don't want to drink out of them. So there you go.
All right.
All right. So the next one is not really Valentine related, but it's kind of New Year's resolution related. So, you know, I know you and I are very active all year long. So if you need something to inspire you to stick with your New Year's resolution of getting fit or keeping fit, I found a new style of workout wear from a company called Wodbottorm, which is W-O-D and then B-O-T-T-O-M, all one word. So Wodbottorm workout wear was created by a gal named Emily, and she is actually a domestic abuse survivor who decided to give back by allowing her patrons to donate to DAIS or DAIS, which is the Domestic Abuse Intervention Services. And off her website, she says, DAIS is incredible and they help so many people, both men and women, find safety from domestic abuse, whether it is helping them create an escape plan or to house survivors and their families. Their impact is great and their work is important. So if you go to their website, they do have a whole line of what they call the dark side. And these are available for pre-order. And it says round two. So apparently they had a round one at some point. But they have shorts that you can work out in. They have half tops, t-shirts, tank tops. There's even some stickers for like your shaker bottles and various styles. And they even have these little, like, they call them Yo Dogs, which are little pugs as Yoda, and then Star Woofs, which are all the dogs that are reimagined as Star Wars characters, stickers for that you can stick on your water bottles, your canteens, you know, that type of thing. One that is they call it the Space Bar, which is a lifting bar with the Death Star on either side of it, like the weights, which is a lot of fun. So some of these you can get unisex. So the t-shirts and things, like, the guys can definitely get on that. And some of the tank tops and of course the stickers and that type of thing. But the shorties are pretty much, I think, exclusively for the gals.
Yeah.
Although, I mean, I guess you guys could wear them too, but there is a whole men's section on Wodbottom. So for the guys, if you want to check that out, you definitely can. But I'm always a sucker for any workout stuff. So I did end up ordering a few things. But what I thought was really cool too, is they do have a variety of different types of fabrics available. So it's not just like one type of fabric. It does depend on what you order though. Some of them just come in a specific type of fabric, but there's a whole section on their website that go into the detail between the buffing, the glide fabric, what they call their OG fabric, the Rena fabric, Moxie fabric, Cali fabric, Flex, Flex Fabric Plus, and then what they call Body Butter, Nearly Naked, and Motley. So tons of different types of things. And then they have a compression rating for each one of them as well, from 1 through 5. So depending on how much compression you're looking for, how much wicking you're looking for, and that type of thing, it kind of goes into it. So I thought that was really cool that they had such a variety of different things like that. So what I ended up getting was the R2 themed bottoms called Robot Shorties instead of Robot. But I got the high rise 5-inch seam, and these are all in the Rena fabric. So you do have your choice between a low rise or a high rise waistband and how long you want your inseam to be. So I did get those. I got the Princess Slaya shorties instead of Princess Leia. We're going to Slaya. And I got the high rise 2.5-inch inseam with the Rena fabric. And then I also ordered the Droids Gym Rocker Tank. So it's like a racer back, and that's in black and white with R2 on the front of it. Basically, you know, lifting some weights. But there's that's also available in a unisex tee. There's size charts on the website. And which is awesome. So I will talk more about those next month. Well, actually, I won't, because we'll be talking about them in March, because it says since this is a pre-order, they will ship the week of March 20th or sooner. So you can't really get this one, obviously, for Valentine's Day. But but yeah, it's a lot of fun. But what you can do when you check out is you can leave them what they call a tip for the dais, the domestic abuse philanthropy that they support, on checkout, in either a percentage of your order cost or a custom amount. And you can deny it if you want to as well. You don't have to leave a tip. So I'm excited about these. I'm in need of some new good workout stuff.
Yeah. No, these, they're fun. Like I said, I think the Droids Gym one is funny. R2 pumping iron there is pretty clever there. And yeah, you're right. The shorts, that's definitely women's apparel. That's a woman's cut. That would not be comfortable for men. Mm-hmm. And, but yeah, I mean, the pew, 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 pew shirt is, and those type of things, that is something more that that anyone could wear. Lift Even Do You Bro, the Yoda pumping iron shirt, that's also pretty clever. So
yep. And then there's a Got Buns with the Leia, Leia buns thing on there. May the gains be with you.
Also looking on this site, that she has a number of pug themed stickers, that one little pug dressed up as Yoda, another is Darth Vader, one is Leia, Han, Chewie, all those. That would be pugs again. You were just talking about tiki culture. That's a whole culture unto itself. And people really enjoy those things.
So yeah, it's so true. Yeah, there's Princess Skywalker, Pug Swolo, Chewpaca, Yodog, all kinds of fun stuff. So again, that is wadbottom.com, and if you just, it's all over their website. So it's right now is what they are definitely advertising the most. So head over there and check it out. So just a couple more things. One thing that we've definitely mentioned before and every year is the Love Pop cards. So it's just worth mentioning for those who are new to World Between Worlds. So if you're not familiar with Love Pop cards, basically these are the cards that when you open them up, they expand into these beautiful 3D sculptures, for lack of a better word. So they're from the website, their mission is to create 1 billion magical moments, and they combine art and engineering to stretch the boundaries of the imagination and create magical cards and gifts that bring people together. Whether you're celebrating a holiday, an important milestone, or an everyday moment, they aim to inspire you to share love with their amazing designs. So they were a Shark Tank 2015 investor winner, just a couple perks that you can get if you do go ahead and get anything from their website. They have free shipping on all U.S. orders. You can personalize some of these online for $5, or you can get a free blank note shipped to you so you can write your own note to go with it. So they have tons of different Star Wars things to choose from. So they have your One in a Millennium pop-up card, which, as you can guess, features the Millennium Falcon. There's the Darth Vader Valentine bundle for $38, which actually comes with this cute little Vader. He almost reminds me of a Lego Vader. And he's holding a heart that says XOXO in one hand, and then a bouquet of roses in the other. And then you get the pop-up roses that I think you got this one before, didn't you? That mm-hmm. has stormtrooper heads and yeah. And the I Am Your Valentine that comes along with it. So there's that one. There's an I Choose You with Chewie, or you can get the Vader by themselves. There's a Grogu, Love is the Way. Boy, that's a very common phrase. Girls could mm-hmm. use that one too. So there's an R2 Valentine pop-up. So there's tons of different types of things here. And a BB-8, Will You BB-8 Mine? That you can pick from. So, but yeah, so the one that you got a couple of years ago, you want to talk about it for just a second?
I've received both the bouquets for my wife that Love Pop does. And she buys Love Pop cards by the dozen and then uses them for a lot of birthdays and things like that. Not all Star Wars, but a lot of their different varieties. And when we were actually in Orlando this past mm-hmm. December, prior to our cruise, we stopped by Disney Springs and Love Pop has a store there. And so we got to walk in and see just the dozens and dozens and dozens of different styles that they had. And it's always quite impressive. And the people who work there are very enthusiastic about it. But we restocked on cards there for various holidays that were coming up and stuff. But that being said, I've kept all of the ones that I've ever had. And I've got Darth Vader, and I think I have a Millennium Falcon one. Like I said, I've received a lot of these over the years. And they're always fun. It's mm-hmm. They have a little insert in the sides that you can sign it there as opposed to on the card itself, so you can kind of keep it as a work of art if you want, as opposed to having signatures all over it. But whatever works for you. So these are always a fun gift to give and get.
Awesome. Yes. And I've gotten a few of them for other holidays as well. And they're just a great little decoration that you can keep out. So mm-hmm. again, that is lovepop.com. And of course, you can go to your local Target, Walmart, Walgreens, basically anywhere, and get all kinds of different types of chocolates and bundles and whatnot. And I know some of the local bakeries and things are jumping on board with doing custom types of cookies that you can order if you get in ahead of time, type of thing. And they have, there's specifically a Valentine's Boba Fett rectangle tin at Target, which I thought was kind of cool. And inside the tin, it's got some Godiva chocolates on it, or not Godiva. That's the ad underneath it. Sorry. Sorry for the false alarm. But there's some wrapped candies on the inside, but the tin is a collectible, nice little tin that you can keep. And so, yeah, so there's all kinds of different things that you can get. There's even sippy cups that have candy on the inside of them for Valentine's Day. And, just your usual suspects when it comes to the cardboard type chocolates and whatnot. So I'm sure you can find chocolates for Star Wars pretty much anywhere you shop. So there you have it.
Yeah. And if Love Pop's not in your budget, I'm pretty certain you can probably find a Star Wars themed Valentine's Day card just in the card aisle, whether you go to a florist or a card shop, Target or whatever. It seems like I find those there anytime I'm looking for a card. For virtually any holiday at this point. Star Wars is still huge business in that regard. So, spend just a few minutes wandering around Target, Walmart, whatever, and I'm sure you'll find plenty of ideas.
Oh, yeah. And I know last year we had also talked about just going on to Amazon and just searching I Love You, I Know, and mm-hmm. you will get so many different products. So if you are, just looking for something random, you can pretty much find that anywhere because, again, that is the phrase that is associated with Star Wars and Valentine's Day.
Yeah, we have those on pillowcases. So
nice. Yeah. Awesome. All right, so that will do it for this month's edition of World Between Worlds. Thank you for listening to Podcast Stardust episode 526. Again, World Between Worlds for February edition 2023. And before we head out, we'd like to remind you that you can find all of our episodes of Podcast Stardust on retrozap.com, where you can subscribe to Podcast Stardust on Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, Google Podcasts, Overcast, or basically wherever you listen to podcasts. We're there. We're also on Spotify, Audible, basically everywhere. And we are part of the RetroZap Podcast Network. You can subscribe to the network feed and get all of the great RetroZap shows in one convenient place. So there's tons of different geekery types of interest over there. So check that out. And if you have a few minutes, please leave us an iTunes review. We would really appreciate that. It helps to boost us up that algorithm and just helps us to be more searchable. And we sure do appreciate the feedback. So if you have a few minutes, you can do that as well. And again, can you remind everybody else where our social media contacts are, Dennis?
Sure. The most convenient place to find us are Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at Podcast Stardust. Jay runs a Pinterest page for the show, which you can find over there. All our episodes are on YouTube, as long as Jay's unboxing videos. Those are a little bit farther back in the feed, so you might have to look for them.
Yeah, they are. I haven't done one in a while.
And you can always come talk Star Wars and other geek topics on the RetroZap Discord server. So if you just went over to RetroZap.com, you can find instructions how to get over there.
Okay, and just one more time, remind everybody you can find my cosplay adventures over on my Instagram, which is at j.snipscosplay. So come check that out. And thanks again for listening, everyone. Until next time, may the force of galactic love be with you.